I will not speak Māori, a line Tame Iti was forced to write over and over and over by his teachers. And today that line, that experience, is the name of his exhibition, which opens to the public today in Wellington's Odlands Plaza. The installation marks 50 years since the Māori language petition was delivered by Iti and Māori activist group Ngā Tamatoa from Tāmaki Makaurau to Parliament in Te Whanganui Ātara, calling for recognition of te reo Māori. You probably know Tame Iti as the activist, and yes, he was, and still is nowadays, in a more reflective and artistic way. But Tame Iti is much more than that. Poet, artist, actor, icon, father, grandfather. I was grateful and humbled to share space in Kōrero on Wellington's waterfront yesterday to reflect on his exhibition, what it means to him, and where we've come in the past 50 years.
Interesting thing, when we first arrived here, we put the screen around here where when we start placing all our tira tumatuma, and so I put the word out there, big writing, I will not speak Māori. The next day we arrived back and I saw a little hole there, and I kind of clapped, oh, somebody took the knot out of it, and I thought, that's great, yeah. So we got that stored up in here, and that's good. That's really what the art is about, the way people respond to it.
What do you want people to get out of the art? What do you want them to get out of this exhibition when they come in and they walk around and they see it all?
Yeah, I think it allows people to express their feelings and their emotions. People didn't realise I would not speak Māori. They thought I was a Pākehā at it. And then when they saw me and they go, they were a little bit confused about it. And I think that's all about it, is it about going through our emotion. And I don't think over the years we dealt with that. Mm. Yeah, and I think that it's really important for us to go through those emotions. And I think our country is still in denial of that, of their own history. And I think it's really important that we bring that and allow us to get the kōrero, have a kai, cup of tea, and share our thoughts. Then we go, things have changed.
50 years ago, when that petition was presented, it was around acknowledging, the government acknowledging te reo Māori. It was also about teaching te reo Māori within our schools. Where do you reckon we're at now? Do you reckon, how far have we
come? I think in terms of te reo, you know, and even some of the people kind of hesitate about that. All this Pākehā speaking my language, you know, that's just, you know, that kind of negativity. But I think there's also a lot of positive thing. I listen to the national station. It just amazes me, you know, the way you got your broadcasters using te reo Māori. You know, it's really, really nice. It's nice to hear that. And you know, when I think about the 17, there was no signs of any movements around that. I'm happy at the moment, because as a result of that, I got my mokopuna, that product of kohanga reo, kurawa kaupapa. I'm excited about the fact that there is a large kind of population of our people in that. Once you get rid of that fear, then you can breathe. Does it really matter how it looks, how it sounds? And I have a belief, I have a dream, I have a voice, I'm still here. I mean, 50 years ago, you think you're nuts.
I think of the mahi that you did and how that's impacting me and my children now.
Yeah.
It's because of you and your generation why I can understand te reo, why I can speak te reo, why I can be on television and speak te reo. And so to listen and to sit in your presence is very humbling. And so again, thank you. Thank you.
I understand. It wasn't an easy road for us to do that.
No.
They call us all kinds of names. Even our own people went through verbal abuse, undermined just our thought. But then we never deter any moments of that, of giving that up. So, you know, So we keep talking to ourselves, you know. So it's really important sometimes I have to talk to myself somewhere, you know. Just talk to the floor.
Where's life now?
Well, I think the life for me is catching up with my children. You know, Nathan, I got my children, they're an intricate part of this, and Wairere Toi, and also my nephew, Archie Depa, and really kind of catching up with them. And they're the one that helped to build the magic. We got to create the magic, create the space for us to be able to be, here we are, Te Hei Wini Wini, Te Hei Māori Ora, all of that.
What is the point to your art and to your art being here in this place?
Well, I think building these figures, and their figures, they become those, they don't have to say anything, just standing there, look at it. What do you see? Is it more about what you see, what you hear, rather than me telling you what it is? What do you see? What do you think?
Nō reira ki a koe, hau hā te wero. What is the challenge?
Find a place. Let's find a place. Let's find a place. So, like you and I sitting here together, enjoy the sun, the wind, the noise of the sea, and have a chat. I got to stop myself going to a space that I don't want to be. Yeah. You know, it becomes a breathing exercise, and you go, and not taking ownership of somebody else's thought. You know, and let it absorb and hit you in the puku. So I just, you know, took and just smile and walk away. Yeah. And carry on doing what I'm doing. That's what I'm doing now. Yeah. I now have the freedom to be able to do the things I want to do. You know, I've done everything for everybody else. For my whānau, for my hapū. I still maintain my relationship with my whānau. And, because they're beautiful. But I want to be in this creative side of me. I'm become the co-creator. And kei roto au I taku I re atua. E I re atanata I re atua. It's a beautiful place to be. You can drink coffee, you can look at everybody, you can look at the ugliness, you can look at the beautiful things. I love that, you know. And just carry on.